team can get picks, but if they can't team fight into this team, then it's gonna be hard to really get picks. And we're going in. Let's take a look at starter builds here. Once everyone loads in. And here we go. Yeah, tier 2 book coming from Thoth. So I'll pick up the Mage's Blessing and Tier 1 Boots. Questionable. Solo's early game clear, already pretty abysmal. And then she's electing to pick up an item that doesn't give her any wave clear. That's very strange. Thoth having the advantage in this early clear against Solo. Thoth's clear as well, very abysmal, but the fact that he's going to have a Tier 2 book, which is going to be an insane amount of power for him early game, is going to help him clear. It's a solo. Dueling had to give a course to red team again. Red team just has they have the Kumba, they have the Rom. A lot of pressure here. Rom being one of the highest pressure ADCs in the game right now, being able to hit all those minions with his autos. X-Ball though hits a lot. Very hard single target damage, so they could win the trade if blue team gets some good shots off.
Minions have spawned.
Colin going for Warrior's Blessing, very questionable as well. Warrior's Blessing hasn't been in the meta for quite a while. Don't get much use for it anymore. Blue team being smart this time. Knowing that red team has pressure in this duo lane, deciding to go for the purple buff once the wave meets. Very questionable how they're starting at the buff instead of going the wave, then buff. If I was red team, I would go straight to this buff over here. See, they are going to start the red. It doesn't get stolen by the jungler. They are going to fight red team on this purple buff. Zombie, though, not picking up the red buff in time. Gonna have a slow rotation of this purple, which is gonna give red team the purple buff. Red team getting their own red buff as well. Gonna be looking for some poke. A little bit late though. Should have done a little bit earlier before they got to the start line. And meanwhile, Smite's UI is literally freaking out. Like, what am I even looking at? What do those even mean? What am I looking at? Yeah, clones of everyone. There's like different symbols popping out on everyone's heads. People's health bars are turning completely blue. What is going on? More trouble here. He's gonna take a lot of damage. Thoth does miss the stun though. Or really poked out here. He really just needs to go and get his backhand. Look at duo though. Red team getting a lot of pressure. Blue team over here already level ahead of both. Now we're gonna look for the poke on the X ball. He's gonna take a huge amount of poke here. This could be first blood here, guys. And it looks like Geb. Did I see Geb kill X ball? What did that even mean? What? Alright, so Rom actually picked up the first blood. You can see at the bottom right corner. He didn't get first blood. Fortunately, Smite's UI is still extremely buggy, and it's just freaking out on me for some reason. Like, look at this, the sky is black. There's nothing going on. Red team is gonna go for this, purple buff, though. Not to worry, not to worry. Blue team has the extra purple clones over there to go farm. Kelly is in the rotation here. They are looking at the Koopa. Koopa is not using that up. They're using that root ability though, unfortunately. So Kelly did not get a knockup to secure the kill. And red team still looking pretty good. Really 500 gold ahead of blue team. Might be in trouble here. He does miss the one on Pele. Not getting the kill. A lot of close calls for red team. Still transitioning well though into this mid game. Once red team gets out of laning phase, they have this game, I think. So calm. There's a lot of damage. Kong knows this and he's gonna go in the air immediately. He's gonna land up the Kong for some poke. He's gonna wait for some rounds. Kong does land the root though. Taking some moderate damage. So Kong is going to ult the wave before he deforms. Red team trying to look for pressure though in this right lane over here. They are looking at the speed buff first and look at the backs. They don't know. They don't know. They're actually looking at mid. They see Thode dash. They are going to go for Thode. He does see the time though. Or he can see every ability. Dodging damage. Rokong does mix up with the auto, but more than last over. He's all over them. Still out of position here. Geb does make the rotation. Can Last Owl get the triple kill? He does get the triple kill. Blue team looking good now as three members of Red picked off in that one fight by Elro, showing that Pele is still a strong high pressure jungler. Like I said at the beginning of the game, Pele is nothing to joke about. You cannot put these low pressure gods jungle here. Not gonna have a fun time. Yes, he is immune against her knockups half the time when he spins, but it's not gonna do a lot of damage. Fortunately, Thor, you're not maxing that hammer and landing all that multiple double taps. It's not gonna be worth for Thor. I would like to see a Talaria boots coming from Pele for those extra rotations and secure more farm. But honestly, Warriors right now is fine. And it actually gets Thor. And she's looking pretty good. Red team, again, getting the purple buff left. If blue team lets this happen too many times, this dual lane's gonna start popping off here soon. I know our team's higher level though. Some reason. Not sure why. But Thode already dashed. He is gonna be in trouble. Gonna get ulted by Kumba, giving some nice setup. Very low though, no mana. Thode is gonna be able to clean this up. Thode's gonna be in trouble though. Don't call him to go in the air because he's gonna land on him. But he does miss the Kong's gonna try to dive this tower, but Geb does shield the Thode, Priscilla. does miss the ultimate though. So Kong's very much out of position here. He's in a lot of trouble. Goomba can get the hit on here. Toth being be able to live in that situation. Very huge. Very huge for Blue. Rom guessing snipes, misses all three, unfortunate. Very questionable decision coming from Hawkeye, pressuring this jungle with no mana. Blue team does not recognize this yet and does not chase him. I can't believe it. They're not chasing him. Wow. And Rom gets away for free. Insane. He does not know about this Pele though. Pele is going to get the blink off. Beads. It's not going to matter because inhaling hurts. You can see why that Crusher pickup, along with the Warriors, just smacking people. Let's take a look at the damage. Overshadowing the Cullen. Meanwhile, So Calm with top damage in the game, 4,500. Not going to make much of a difference though, as Blue Team is leading this game. Grass Show, it's not much of a lead, but Blue Team is going to have to take it. Blue Team is going to secure these mids. Thor getting the purple buff. Stealing the XP from his ROM. I'm actually confused as why he did that. He has back camps and right, and he could just split with Scylla in mid. Instead, he gives up pressure in mid. Because of that, Blue Team is going to be chasing the long dual lane over here. Goomba might be in trouble. Goomba is going to be able to back off though, because he is Goomba. So peel is not a problem. These oracles, and they do. They have vision now on Gold Fury. Red team's going to be wary around these Gold Fury fights now. They have to wait out that timer. Last throw, I'm looking at Rom again, but not going to be able to hit it. A late X ball, unfortunately, which allows Rom to get out. Blue team looking for some picks again against this red team, trying to pressure the jungle. Last Elric, by the way, getting some kills though in the backline. MX double, actually not being killed by anyone and being killed by the tower. Huge win for Blue Team. Now I'm gonna look at this duo lane. Rom is out of position. They did catch him on that ward though, so Rom should know that they're coming. He's gonna be able to dash out, but it's gonna matter. Taylor's gonna hit him coming on this. Rom this time. Pele ult, but it's not gonna matter. Pele is. Goomba is gonna be here for heal though. Yep, is gonna be able to pick up the kill. And interesting that. Great rotation by Thor, by the way. Picks up the kill on Pele, and they get 3 kills on Blue Team. Excuse me. And gets the kill. My call. Really just making an impact on this game. Just running at people. Holding down that joystick with no tomorrow. No answer. I'm sure DJ Big Daddy isn't too happy about this game. Alright, look how many minions are right there. Oh my goodness. It's a fat wave for Rom, if I do say so myself. This is very bad for X-Ball. He's 2 levels down from Rom. Rom is getting a huge waves because blue team keeps stacking them. Rom doing a really good job of denying farm from next. Kumba looking the pressure that's dueling once again. Is gonna back off though and look for the red buff instead. Both Thoth and Geb are gonna make the rotation though to secure it. But they know, they may secure it though. Actually, no, they like to go for oracles instead. The safer option. All four members of red team all grouped in left lane. Or left jungle. More Wailing Mage missing that one from the top. Or looking for Ward's place now. Are you kidding? Elruk trying to look for a pick here. That's wrong. Mom, but we'll have to dash out though. Kumba does miss the group, unfortunately. Last Elruk having to beat down all four members of the red team start to rotate. Red team trying to look for a fight around this Gold Fury. They want it, they're hungry for it. They have soul. Blue team, 9 group of 5 right now. Pressure on this. DJ Big Daddy in huge trouble here, and he goes down by the Kumba. Huge root coming from red team to secure the kill on Thoth. Apologies, my mic. Ooh, what's going on here? And the last Eric diving their backline again. Killing the fade! I can't believe they're just letting this happen. Red team, please. Red team. And they do pick up the Cerberus. Not the Cerberus. The Cacolin. So far, no objectives taken by either teams. Very just back and forth fights. Picks left and right. Refarming. Up to it because I don't have any batteries, so I just plug that in, and it's a bad habit of falling out on me, unfortunately. So sorry, you keep seeing that message pop up. Red team going to rip up this 5 here. Actually, Thor going, not sure what to do, he looks lost in that right jungle over there. D warding on right lane for some reason, not sure why, as all of red are kind of focused. Give him free vision on Gold Fury. Rom over here getting huge pressure on the Pele. Rom will be chasing, gets the Geb out of his rollout. Huge red team, gonna get the pick on Geb. Geb is going to have the arc out. Geb is going to be right now. We'll have it as well. Our red is on the guys. Oh my goodness, DJ Big Daddy getting the double kill with the Thoth ultimate. Just turn this fight around completely. Red team has to get out of here right now. Get out of here. They opened up the door though. Big fuel though coming from Kumba with the stun. I'm trying to fight with this Colin. Looking very low though. I know Red team nice and healthy after coming back. He is be able to rotate this fight. Red team has to be careful. They need to get out of this. Alright, what is this? Where did this come from? Alright. Blue team is bringing up the gold turret here. Very big fight for him. From now on. Take a look at the graph. Huge spike in favor of blue team. 3k ahead in experience. Almost 2k in gold. Now this is where blue fights are on fire giant. That fire giant. Their team fights are really, really good right now. While they're winning. If they keep playing around that, then I think they can. Kong out of position here. Trying to look for something, but will instead just get poked down by Thoth. Thoth doing a lot of damage. Someone Kong having zero magical protections. Oh my goodness. Thoth just doing true damage to this point on Sun Kong. Only a third pen item. Very, very questionable. Not sure why. His passive is already giving him about 30 pen as it is. He already has 10 pen shields, 15 pen, I believe, from Divine, which is going to pretty much overcap him by at least 10. Thor's ace is gonna wear off. He is gonna have to ult out with the ult out in time. No, DJ Big Daddy. DJ Big Daddy comes in with rotation. First farming zone. Hits a double. Still is at half health. Going here. Matt Elric. Picking up. Come on. Down. As he's gonna get picked up by Last Elric. Oh, yes. There we go. Double kill for Last Elric. Oh, it's Last Elric and Thoth popping off in these fights. Last Elric with its top player damage, 13,000. Last Elric, 11-1 as well. What a game. Why you should never let Pele go through. Very late. He is going down. He's going to lose his passive and his ultimate. Very big win for blue team. Now blue team gets the fire, gets the pyro, like they're pushing these waves up. Four towers still up for red team. Blue team's gonna look to take out all these towers. Huge poke in the back line. Thor gets really pressured out. He doesn't look up to go up here. Hell, he knows he's doing. He is using him to juke back and forth to make sure he can't get Mavis. He's going to miss that as well. He has a lot of abilities. Pele getting the kill on Thor. Look at mid lane. He's going to get hit by the Colin. He's not going to do enough there. Shut up, he got the kill. Has 5, seeking out his tower. Looks like they're trying to go right now. Looks like they're just gonna back off. Shell already used. Geb gets picked. What happened? Looks like blue team has reset here. Just wait for everyone to get healthy again. Looks like they're gonna go left and push down those towers. Blue team, all 5 alive, all healthy. Well, except for Geb, who's now up and alive and healthy. Red team getting a lot of pressure on these waves. Push them forward. farther back, we're just gonna delay blue team even further, sieging these towers. Rom being the biggest level on level 14. Only person that's higher than Rom is the Pele, and she just hit level 20. Last Elric popping off this game. Blue team gonna get these towers. Huge damage. X-Ball auto combo to both walls. It's just insane damage. It's really hard to stop the combo. Rom does a few beats in her throat, but it's done. Blue team right there. Red team, try to look for a pick outside the Phoenix. I'm not sure what they're trying to do here. I'm not sure what they're trying to do. Very awkward spot in the red team. Red separated. And Phoenix is able to shoot. Get the late pick on Rom. Yep, so to look for this door here. His aim is down, he doesn't get the blink off just in time to save himself. Pele, that's huge damage, but it doesn't matter because Pele, Pele does a lot of damage. Come on, we're gonna have to ball out of the view. Phoenix here. Oh, he's looking for a kill, and he landed. He's gonna miss. Backline using his ultimate to start the fight. DJ Big Daddy in big trouble. DJ Big Daddy going down. Kelly's gonna go down as well. Two picks for red team. Huge picks. Red team gonna start taking left down left lane. Yep's gonna roll out and get out of the X-Ball. Blue team really needs to get out of this fight right now. Cole not sure what he's doing back there in that backline over there. One against Thor, he can do it. He is going to transform. He picks up the 1v1 kill against Steelio. Red team finally recognizes the backline is trying to go fight it. Colin, too much health. Too much health. He only ward off the guy. Rush, Dev coming in. Huge give ultimate. It's going to give Colin out of this fight. Quick chill is going to use it. Karna. Won't land a stun though on Colin. Down. But X-Ball goes back in the fight. X-Ball is the first fight. Geb gets to pick up the kill. And they're gonna look to get the Kumba out there as well. Oop, flop. Yeah, feels bad, man. Feels bad. Right in the middle of commentating, too. That's where it only does it well. Right in the middle of, like, getting it. Looks like someone wants to look at a Gold Fury here. Not sure why though, as we're 25 minutes in the game. Fire Giant is up. Still looking strong. Not a lot of relics up for Red Team right now. Very bad situation for them. We have to wait out for these relics until they can start the next fight. No shell or no sprint is going to be death for a lot of these characters. Meanwhile, blue team, they're with 40 seconds on that Aegis, 4 seconds on the Meads. Looks like blue team will be ready to fight soon. A lot of times, these fights are really determined by relics. If you don't have relics, you shouldn't fight. So. Huge damage from X-Ball. Oh my goodness. That's gonna throw off this fight. Blue team nice and well. Yep, very questionable play right here. No one around to really follow up. Very questionable play from Gem. Looks like the knockup though, kinda throws away everyone. More opposition though. But last arrow holds secure the kill on forward. The car does have a hold out here. Two members of the rest are tearing down the blue team. The blue team are trying to get this wrong. They're trying to get this wrong. Down. go here, try to see himself. Trying to peel away everyone. Blob. Blob does dash out. But is it going to be enough? Kelly's too fast. Kelly's too fast. Kelly is too fast. Pick up by Dev once again. Ooh, wait, picking up a lot of kills. Kong in the head. I don't understand what I'm seeing right now. Because it keeps telling me that that teammates are killing their teammates. I don't know what you're dealing with. Good group by Killa. Really good group. Kelly will not be able to land that knockup. Why is it keep annoying? Rom, 7-6 now. Not looking as good as he once before. X-Ball though, still level 18. Really needs to start farming up so he can make more of an impact in these fights. Yep, still level 17 as well. Wards from Kumakarna, 9 from Geb. 0 wards coming from Rom. Very weird. You should never let go a game without wards. Ever. No matter who you are. No exception to the rule. Always get wards, friends. Always get wards. Blue team is gonna get this Pyramid before this Fire Giant. Red team knows that they're doing this. It's gonna try to stop them here. No, they're just gonna let them have it. Red team's Red team trying to pick up that left wave as the Phoenix is still down. Red team now gripping up for the bird. Red team really needs to pick and choose these fights. They should not be going in on these mid camps. They really need to look at the fire giant. I don't think you let him have this. I think he's good. I think you have to stop him. Red team is there for free. I am contested by red team. Ellie doesn't go in here. She does a lot of damage. Fire Giant is OP. She is going on this on the board. Gets out and he's able to ult away, but Scylla, not the same situation for her as she gets picked off by Shadow. 4-5. Not sure if the red team today are able to handle this as their main viewer is now dead. Kumakarn is going to ult the back line. He's going to ult a zombie. Zombie looking pretty low. Laying some big damage on the Kumba. This is gonna back off red team. Blue team getting chased away from Phoenix. Blue team is just not on the same targets. Everyone's just throwing their damage on different people. Another late game here, boys. There was so many clones everywhere. Nice backwards autos. Too much going on right now as both teams are resetting. Zombie though still has Fire Giant buff. Huge for blue team. Small should really be able to pick up this this red buff as it's really gonna help him for this siege. Use it for Thoth. Hit the The planet is for blue team. Alright, so our structure push is like the best structure push in the game. Let's just go for structures. So, oh, it's the Phoenix when we get the Phoenix. Put the glyph wall with X ball and Thoth auto the Phoenix, and it's literally dead in no time. Instead, we're just seeing a lot of just like back and forth fights and people looking for picks, pokes. Oop, last Elric actually going in on this Scylla here. Chance would go down. The Colin makes the rotation as well. And last Elric is going to Scylla again to start off this fight. Red team, without their mid lane, again. You can start monkey with the rotation. It is going to force out him the all out here. Four, looking at mid, trying to push up this wave. Trying to look for an ultimate. He is calling a ward here. They do know he's here. Now what he does know is he's facing him. All this. Pretty low here. Shell popped by red team. Afraid of the Thoth ultimate. No vision. Red team not bad for red team. Thor trying to go in the back line. Doesn't need much. Oh my goodness. That back line. That's no one picked up huge kills, but Fortune was taking the Phoenix and got picked as well. Now we're on the same page. Huge stun by Thor. A lot of damage though. And it's sniped by DJ Big Daddy. Close range. So immediately come in the fight with an ultimate. Trying to look at this wall. Hits him, but Fortune kind of saves the day. Oh, Phoenix on life again, killed by minions. And blue team. Blue team can win the game. I blame the ultimate for Kuma can't do much. But he's gonna look for the X-Ball, trying to block those autos. X-Ball auto is doing too much damage. Kuma gonna have to ult. Oh my goodness. Getting the double kill. I'm not sure if he's actually getting put up here because. Yeah, he actually did get the double kill. Nice job. Kool-Aid really saving that Titan. With the double kill. Blue team, I don't think they what they want to do. Last Elric really diving this backline, but unfortunately, it's causing him to get caught out as the rest of his team is not following up. I'm not sure what's happening. Maybe some miscommunication going on with the team. Blue team, though, in position to get this fire giant. Unfortunately, all three members of blue are down. Red team, all five are alive. Very low health. Elric at 35k damage, passing all members of red and blue. Poke from that fire giant. Hopefully, blue team looking for this middle Phoenix, trying to get pressure in all waves. Red team now in position to defend. That's still a huge damage. It's insane. Last Elric dying his backline. Jimmy Dyer gets me a kill. Thor misses the stun for his ultimate. Last Elric picks up a backline. Thor laying in the team. Which team comes back and wins the game. Huge win for blue team. Very nice job, guys. That was a good game. These games have been really good. Last Elric, 38k damage. Passes the ROM. Scylla, only 6k damage. 1 in 12. Just being bullied this entire game by Filth and Pele.